This is a piece of 12mm acetal. It's very similar to Delrin, although I think this is the slightly softer version. Delrin's meant to be more durable. I'm going to do a practice cut of one of my parts, redesigned parts for the CNC machine. I'm going to cut this plate here with a mount so I can actually fit the proximity sensor onto it properly, sort of cable tying it the way I've done it there. This is just a test. What I'm planning to do is to drill the holes at first, the mounting holes, and then I'll screw the block down onto the MDF, and then I'll cut out the profile shape. To do this in BCNC, I positioned the bit above the area I wanted to probe, and then set the X, Y, and Z coordinates. I then set the probe along the Z direction to minus 10, and made sure the contact plate hadn't moved away from the incoming bit. Once they made contact and had stopped, I typed the command G92Z1.51. G92 sets the position of the bit end, and Z1.51 is the thickness of the touch plate along the Z axis. I raised the bit, returned the dust shoe, and ran the first stage of the cutting job. This is the visualization of the cutting job in BCNC. So far, no problems. Okay, that seems to cut okay. I'm just going to press the home button now. So I move the spindle away from the workpiece, and that's just going to give me room to get the drill in and to screw the piece down. Doesn't look like a bad cut. Okay, down. So I could change the bit to a larger one to do the remaining cuts. Not sure how confident I feel about doing that. That feels nice and soft, nothing feels like it's melted. I think I'll just stick with the bit as it is. So I'm going to put these back. Have to probe that again. It looks like it's in the right position on the X and Y, but the Z is a lot higher. So I shouldn't press home next time I need to move the spindle out of my way. I reprobed the bit and then exported the next set of cuts from ArcCam. Come out really nice. This material feels like Teflon. Before I unscrew it, just going to push the bearing in, and that's gone in perfectly. That is a really good sign. I haven't missed any holes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 12.5, 12.4, that's pretty good. I tapped the holes for the stepper motor bracket and began dismantling the original Z motor plate. I think when I build this again properly and do the rest of the plates, I don't think I'll be using the stainless steel machine screws. They're just a little bit too soft, the high tensile, the 10.9 ones. Just feel a lot more rugged. So there's always something you overlook when you're designing, and it's only when you actually start to put things together you realise what that was. And in this case, it's this locking washer, which is meant to go between the nuts on the proximity sensor, and this is just a little bit too low, by about 1 or 2 mil only, so I will change that on the design. I was planning on using 8mm acetal to keep the cost down, but I decided to go with 12mm because it's thicker and will be more rigid. But it's also the same thickness as the original plates, which will mean I don't have to change too many parts when upgrading, such as the stepper motor spacers, which I've already cut to size. I'm really happy with the test piece, it's cut out really well and feels very rigid. It even looks like halloumi. As for whether it's a good material for CNC plates, only time will tell. If it's good enough for the wheels, I feel like it will be good enough for the plates. This Aceto is a copolymer and is the cheaper version as opposed to Delrin, which is a homopolymer. In case you're interested, I ran the job with a spindle speed of 1500 RPM, a feed rate of 620mm a minute, a plunge rate of 200mm a minute, a step down of 1mm and a step over 25% of the bit width. I bought the test piece of Aceto online from eBay, but will probably use RS Tools or the plastic people for the remaining material. So now I need to go and make some changes to the Fusion 360 file. Okay, so I've just made some changes to the plates. I've changed the thickness to 12mm. I've decided not to use 8mm acetal and go with 12 instead. But since I've done that, I've had to change the positioning of the proximity sensor opening. So I've adjusted this one here. I had a few areas where I didn't have constraints on some of the openings and they were shifting. So I've changed that. And I've also done the rear one as well. So that's more or less in the center. It's not perfect, but it will do. I've done the top as well. Ignore that hole, I have to get rid of that. But essentially I'll be drilling the holes for machine screws to trigger the proximity sensors manually, and as the design is now, I'll just have to do it in the center. And the last thing I need to do is the Y plates. You can see that's a little bit off. I'm just going to right click, edit sketch profile, rotate around. Shit. I want the proximity sensor mount to shift towards the slope and not push the mounting holes out of alignment. I would make a change and press Ctrl Z and Ctrl Y repeatedly, trying to spot anything that had changed which would affect the overall design. I'm going to pause it while I figure this out and then. Okay, I've just fixed a load of lines and I think that has solved the movement. I'm just going to change that back to 8, enter. It's moved. I really need a bigger screen, so I'm going to press Ctrl Z. You can see, it's very weird, you can't see everything on my screen because I'm cropping down to 720. It's really weird,
It's weird that the constraints are not on those sections there, because I don't think I would have deleted it. Okay, screw that. I'm going to pause you again while I work this out. See if this is going to work. I've deleted the lines, I've selected the ones I want to mirror. I've click on that, press OK. Okay, looks better. Nothing looks like it's moving. That shouldn't be moving. Looks okay. Moving along a little bit, but everything looks fine. So if I leave that at 8, I'm going to stop the sketch and then I'll check the actual component. Looks a little bit better. Maybe I've moved too much. I think when you're doing something like this, don't be afraid to take pictures of the screen or even write notes for yourself, because it can get very confusing. You're relying on your short-term memory, and you know, you've got lots of numbers and lines on the screen that, okay, it's almost there. You might think you've moved something to the left, and then you check and you've actually moved it to the right. It's how you add errors to what you're designing, and to overcome that, the best thing to do is to just try and keep notes. So again, ignore that circle there, that hole, that won't be part of the design. I think that is something I'll cut out myself. I think that's fine. Okay, these are the final changes. I thought I'd just cut straight to the end. I've added some curvature to the spindle mounts just to help support the spindle. I felt like it was getting a bit thin on the sides. This actually looks like quite a interesting feature as well. I think it's quite distinct for a CNC machine. Also, with the mini V-wheels on the sides, and there'll be some at the bottom here, I've extended the material around the mounting hole just so it isn't so close to the edge, and that additional material, as with this gantry bit here, should help to support the wheels a little bit better. So my next stage is to start cutting out the pieces. I've bought a 500 by 500 millimeter square of 12 mil and a 25 centimeter by 25 centimeter square of 16 mil white acetal. I need to work out how I'm going to nest the pieces so that I can get an efficient cut section by section. Anyway, I hope you check out some of the other videos of the build towards this CNC machine, and don't forget to check out my Patreon page where I provide advanced or additional materials accompanying my videos. Anyway, thanks again for watching, and you'll catch me in the next one. Thank you.